What's going on YouTube? Welcome back to another video. I'm out here at the Richard Stockton rest area off the Jersey Turnpike. Not a lot of real estate out here. So I'm getting a nice little evening walk in. Got some drama buzzing on the YouTube waves. I figured I'd just weigh in on it. But before I get rolling into the video, make sure to ring that bell and hit subscribe. Like this video and comment down below. With that, let's get to it.
When the moon hits your eye like a bigger pizza pie, that's amore.
You're listening to Lombard Trucking.
When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine.
All right, guys, so let's get right into it. There are a lot of popular trucker YouTubers out there who are deciding to get out of the game. I mentioned him a few episodes ago. Ken V, he's gone. Other than that, Scooby-Doo, gone. 21 Trucking, gone. Toe Piglet, gone. All these guys have decided now is the time to throw in the towel and hang it up. And look, I don't fault anybody for doing this. I mentioned it a few episodes ago. There's nothing wrong with starting a business, growing it, and selling it off. What I have a problem with is the fashion in which it's being done and the trend of it and the trend of negativity. I don't mean to insult anyone's character. I'm not trying to disparage these guys or talk any sort of shit about them. But I have a problem with how they've done it. This isn't the airport. You do not need to announce your departure out here. I think their negativity is having a ripple effect across the industry. It's affecting guys like me, their subscribers, other drivers, other people out there, the overall, general public. Look, these guys have 50 to 100,000 followers on YouTube. Their videos are getting out. And when people see their messages and their whys and everything like that, it doesn't give good trends out there for the market to look at and be like, oh, everything's going to be okay. So another thing is these guys, I've watched a lot of their content. They're all about manifesting, working hard, grinding, persevering through the hardest moments because that's where you're going to find success, all that sort of thing. And I'm not saying that they haven't had hard times or rough events happen, but guess what? The hardest time has just come. This right here is the ultimate test. Unprecedented fuel prices, brokers trying to bottom out rates, inflation, Fed's about to hike interest rates again. There's all this going on, and now they've decided to pop smoke when now is really their time to shine and help guys like us out and help other drivers out. We need their platforms to get out there, to get their messages out there, to talk to other people throughout the industry, politicians, brokers, you name it. Well, guess what? They're gone now. But guess what? I'm not going anywhere. The only way through is forward. So I ask that since they're gonna be making less videos and they're not gonna be on the road as much, I'm asking you right now for your support towards me, because I'm sticking around. I'm getting in the fight. It's time to fix bayonets. That's one of these moments. This is the little round top moment of starting a business or being a driver or being in the trucking industry. So that same energy you gave these guys, come on board with Lombard Trucking. Go subscribe to my buddy, the Travel Trucker. We're out here. We're fucking teammates, brothers out here in this. It's time to fix bayonets and get after it. So when it comes to my content, I can tell you right now, I'm not stopping. I'm going forward. I'm looking for this to grow. I need more subscribers because guess what? Chip Roy, he's my congressman. I'm coming for you. Senator Ted Cruz, I'm coming for you. John Cornyn, I'm coming for you. I'm going to start banging on these doors. Governor Abbott, I'm coming for you. Pete Buttigieg, I'm coming for you. President Biden, I'm coming for you. We are going to talk. I'm not going to stop until these guys are personally hearing my voice and the concerns of the industry. These guys who are quitting now, we need their platforms now more than ever to start rattling cages, to getting the word out there, to talk about the freight rates, the fuel prices, trucker conditions, safe parking, restrooms, detention pay, you name it. We need guys out there advocating. Guess what? They're popping smoke and getting out. I'm fixing bayonets out here. So if you made it this part of the video, comment down below, LT, fix bayonets. We're moving forward. We're getting after it. I'll see you guys on the next video.